begin my speech with a few thanks to this guy. He gave me his business card on the lunch break. He's Adi Gerleanu, the guy that provided the catering from enjoycatering.ro, because he put out some light food. I didn't expect any of you to be awake after lunch. So thank you, Adi, for having us on here. When I was invited by this crazy bunch of kids. By the way, can we have a round of applause for this bunch of kids? I really need to bribe them because I need them to help. So when I was invited to come to speak to TED, the first question was, do you know what TED is? Yes, I knew what TED is. The second thing I had was, we have three video projectors. So as you know, pretty much the second thing. Okay. As you know, we in advertising, the ones of you that are clients, we tend to use the whole budget. So this is why I'm going to use all three screens. Okay? This means that I'm going to try to click this one here, and we have two guys over there trying to keep the pace with me. So if there's any unsynchronizing thing going on behind me, please be gentle to the guys and to myself. When I was called to talk about the essence of change, and then when I learned that some of these presentations could go on TED Global, guys, okay, I looked at all these big things, okay, let's talk about Obama, let's talk about, I think, Bassam, you quoted this guy earlier, right? Let's be the part of the change you want to see in the world, and so on. And then I looked at my life, tried to make it a little bit more local, and I asked myself, what the hell is there to change? I work in advertising. We are paid huge, undeserved salaries. Everybody knows who I am. People call me Batman in the street, and Laser Brother, and so on. I drive a Lexus. I have two Harley Davidsons. Why the hell would I change anything? But then, with my Harley Davidson, or with my Lexus, I have to drive on the same streets as you guys do, through the same holes. With the Lexus, I can avoid listening to Manele music at every traffic sign. With the Harley Davidson, I didn't have that, but then I have really loud pipes, so I can bump them all a little bit, okay? Tough question. I know this is a bunch of very successful people, but are you happy with what's going on right now in Romania? From 5-0 or 0-5 with Serbia to not having a government, to whatever you see each day on TV, whatever you see, you read each day in the papers. Let me show you a bit of my Romania. Well, can I wait? Can we play this thing, if it works? And now, the other
one. V-ați întâlnit noi cu Diaconata. Era un reportaj cu noastră la chestia că ați luat-o. Auziți? Ați luat-o după Caterinca, dar uitați să ne spună instrucțiunile. Publicitate. Nu, știu, poți să mai rămâne și ce știu. Ultima dată am fost văzut pe TV Sport.
I hope you're applauding my presentation. A country where a TV star is outselling with her first book, the Nobel Literature Award winner. a country where the top three newspapers are tabloids in terms of sales, outselling almost by 3-1 the first quality newspaper in the country. A country, last year, we had the mayor's elections in Bucharest. The final debate between the top two candidates was broadcast in Oralitatea TV, and it was watched by 5 times less people than Acasa TV and OTV during the same hours, where they were watching Gypsy Heart, I don't know what episode, and another episode from Elodia, the quest to eternity for Elodia. Okay. 5 times more people each, so this is 10 times more people looked at Elodia and Gypsy Heart than caring about who's going to be the mayor in Bucharest, which, as we all know, is a city completely without any problems, so who cares for the mayor? Sad thing is, this is Romania. Is it your Romania? Is it the same Romania where we have Ted and the same guys here, and a bunch of kids managed to pull this off? Is it my Romania? I can write my Harley Davidson pool anywhere outside the country and not see this kind of Romania. What we do, we don't see this Romania. We're locking it out. We say, this is not us. Us, we get together with a bunch of friends. We go to wherever, to a nice restaurant, they have some French wine and I don't know what kind of fancy food. And we say, this is their Romania. We are different. Well, no, it's not my Romania. I believe it's not your Romania either. And there's a newspaper that didn't think so either. And they didn't think so some years ago. It's a newspaper that I didn't read. I haven't read it for years, because for me it had a label, I knew who owned it. I thought it was linked to politics, I didn't care about it, I never read it. I was reading Academia Cazavecu, and that was pretty much it. Actually, it was the most read quality newspaper in the country, however, which for 4 years already, it stopped writing about, now my foreign colleagues here, I think you won't know who I'm talking about properly. But 4 years they stopped writing about Irinel Shimonica, about I don't know what kind of football player's girlfriend and so on, and about scandals. Instead, they wrote about morality, they wrote about principles, they wrote about culture. I didn't know it, I haven't read it. I wasn't reading it. They wrote about Romanian values. Every week they were they were giving with the newspaper a classic Romanian book. So not necessarily any book just to sell the newspaper, but a classic Romanian book. Every week they had a classic CD. Most of them, 95% of them Romanian. Together, and this is nice to observe, together with a 60-page story about the artist on the CD. For instance, they wrote about Dona Dumitru Siminica. Okay? He was popular music player, died for ages. Nobody is alive that ever knew him. 30 people in the newspaper, from the newspaper, worked for 3 weeks to find out about this guy. It's much easier to take some news from the internet and write about two scandals and sell the newspaper than do this. Every week a classical Romanian movie. For 1 year, every day, they had an investigation about the revolution in 1989. Every year, they make this folk music festival. Whoever has been to Vama Veche this year probably saw it together with myself. I didn't know that. I didn't know that. I wasn't reading the newspaper. Okay? It was called Journal Național, the National Journal. It was Voiculescu's. Who's going to read it? It's Felix, it's the moguls, it's why read it? Because they do all this stuff. So, the way I saw it is that for years, Journal Nacional was resisting whatever was happening in the rest of the media and in the country as a whole. They asked me for a commercial to promote their CD, their weekly CD. I looked at what they're doing and I said, no, let's do something bigger. Let's fight back, because I like very much what was going on over there. And let's try to bring together all the people that resisted like you did. And unfortunately, to your presentation earlier, everybody, and there are a lot who resist whatever's going wrong in the country, they are resisting alone. Everybody knows about himself. They don't know about the others. There are a lot of them. Some of them probably are, if not all of you, are here. Let's get together, everybody who is resisting alone, from the old guys, from the elders, to the young. Okay? Catherine, you can see yourself over there. There are a lot of guys in a lot of places and jobs and fields in Romania that are doing the right thing. Maybe they should do it together somehow. In an open fight against mediocrity, quality against quantity, timeless values against the one-hit wonders, a fight to regain somehow our pride and our decency, we called it La Resistance, the movement of resistance. And it was Marius Cucă who spoke first, inviting people. Și acum clip, please.
Pentru mine, mișcarea de rezistență e felul meu de a fi. Pentru mine, mișcarea de rezistență e felul meu de a face jurnalism. Pentru mine, mișcarea de rezistență este declarația mea de independență față de lumea în care trăim. Sunt Marius Cucă și vă chem la mișcarea de rezistență.
This was the first one that went out. This was the first call. You can see the print ads translated in English for anybody who wants to understand whatever is going in the movie. And the call was heard by a lot of people. A lot of people who called, who emailed, who asked to be filmed, to come on the screen for free and get their message heard by everybody in Romania. This is one of the first.
Când vă uitați la știrile violente, vedeți spectacol și divertisment. Eu când mă uit, văd câte echipaje de intervenție își vor pune viața în pericol și câți doctori vor sta în sală de operație ore întregi ca să salveze victimele accidentelor și actelor de violență. Văd copii care nu vor mai avea șansa la fericire și la educație pentru că părinții lor tocmai au murit într-un accident de circulație. Văd familii care vor suferi o viață întreagă datorită violului unui descreierat. Dacă n-ați fi atât de mulți care vedeți doar spectacolul, reporterii n-ar mai lucrui în durerea unor oameni. Nu ar adăuga durerii lor rușine de a fi văzuți de o țară întreagă. Stă în puterea noastră să fim mai buni decât atât. Sunt doctor Raed Arafat și susțin mișcarea de rezistență. Mi-ar plăcea să susțin această mișcare alături de mine, inspectorul general al Inspectoratului General pentru Situații de Urgență, domnul general locotenent Vladimir Seca.
De când am intrat în sala de gimnastică, antrenorii și colegele au devenit ca o a doua familie pentru mine. Am stat împreună 24 de ore din 24, zi de zi în sală, timp de 15 ani. Aveam două antrenamente pe zi, 4 ore de dimineață și 4 seara, iar între ele, școală. De obicei, generațiile mici și ale modele pe care să le urmeze, așa cum și noi am ales-o pe Nadia. Acum putem alege între cei care au valoare și cei care au doar imagine. Vă întreb pe voi, poate deveni model cineva care are ca singură ocupație participarea la evenimente mondene? Sau o persoană al cărei unic succes este apariția pe prima pagină a unui tabloid? Eu am ales să cred în campioni, în oameni obișnuiți care schimbă mentalități și obțin rezultate extraordinare. Sunt Andreea Răducan și susțin mișcarea de rezistență. Mi-ar plăcea să susțină mișcarea de rezistență Raed Arafat, Ivan Pațaichin și Marcel Iureș.
Politică? Măi, fraților, de când de mitește politicieni? Când mă gândesc în Anglia. Îi fac din tată în fiu, când fost muzicant. Unicii mei de 300 de ani sunt muzicanți. Ăștia când au făcut atâta politică? De unde știu ei atâtea lucruri? Adică ca să fur bani, să faci mizerie, de fapt nici nu trebuie să știi nimic.
Sunt John Răducanu și voi sprijini totdeauna această mișcare de rezistență. Aș dori să se alăture toți prietenii mei. Vă rog, aliniați-vă că s-ar putea chiar arunca o lingvă în ocean, dar ne-am făcut datorie.
Dacă politica înseamnă să promiți înainte de alegeri parcuri pentru copii, blocuri pentru tineri, refacerea străzilor și, în schimb, să faci niște topogane înconjurate cu garduri de pușcării, apartamente în care cad tavanele și să pui borduri noi în tot Bucureștiul, atunci suntem toți în rahat. Sunt Dragoș Bucur și susțin mișcarea de rezistență. Mi-ar plăcea să vină cu mișcarea asta și fii mea. Sofie.
Ce-s? 2 years old? 1 year old?
Mă gândesc acum la campioana olimpică de maraton, care atunci când se antrenează trebuie să suporte un tir cu mici din partea celor care fac grătar pe marginea drumului. Mă gândesc la canătoarele de pe Snagov, care deranjează pe domnii cu bani, pe oamenii de afaceri din România, care sunt foarte deranjați de prezența sportivilor pe lacul lor. Mă gândesc la un domn sprinter român, care a alergat alături de Asafa Paul și care acum este în Germania și lucrează în construcții pentru că la noi în țară murea de foame. Mă gândesc la campioana noastră de not, care vrea să se lase de sport pentru că Federația Română de Specialitate n-are bani să-i mai plătească antrenorul. Mă gândesc și la campionul nostru de sărituri în apă, care se întâlnește cu apa doar la concurs, pentru că atunci când face antrenament, sare doar pe bureți. Și mă gândesc mai ales la ipocrizia noastră, care îi numim sportivii noștri. Care ai noștri? Sunt Mircea Badea și susțin mișcarea de rezistență.
Ok, there are a lot of them. Actors, singers, composers, TV hosts, doctors, as you've seen, directors, and so on. One thing only, should we go in, please? Anything but politicians. We're trying to keep the whole thing out of politics, because it's very easy to get in the same fight and in the same, how do you call it? The trowel, if you get in it, the pigs eat you. We're not going to go there. It's already over 30 people came and support the resistance on 3 TV channels. There's a dedicated website where not only you can read a lot of articles that are stamped with La Resistance, where you can see all the movies, but also where you can join the movement, you can sign in for the movement, and actually it's you can't sign with a nickname like in Petition Online. What you have to do is you need to give your name, your address, your email, your phone number. You have to stand up if you want to join. It's already 24 articles that were stamped with La Resistance, hundreds of emails. I'll just very quickly read you this one. It's from a lady that runs a Casa newspaper in Canada that goes, she says it goes to 200,000 Romanians in Canada, who asked to take the banner of the movement and to take all the articles of the movement and print them again in Canada to get to the 200,000 people. This is their way to resist and to join the resistance. And so far, 2,500 people have signed for the movement. And it's been only 3 weeks. So, the thing that I've been asked over and over again is where this thing is going to go once we get the people. You'll see. The first thing that we do, on the one hand, of course, acknowledging everything Journal National has done over these years, but I think the most important thing that we do so far is give hope to all the guys that are resisting alone over the country. They see a lot of people that they know, that they trust, that they like, thinking the same way as they do. From all the comments that we received on the website, from all the comments that all these people made, all these 30 people made, so far 30, we're shooting next week, I think 7 more. I was left with one thought about change. And yes, I know that TED is all about new technologies and going forward and embracing whatever, Twitter, Facebook, Wiki, whatever you call them. But I think that what we need right now, at least in this resistance, let's say, is not a step forward, but rather a step back. A step back to principles and values and decency. We used to be that way. We should remember it. While taking in Wiki and Twitter and Facebook and everything else, I think we should remember some stuff about values and decency. It's 30 seconds. Nimm ich mein Mut, Vicenza, assai mi scara, persistenza, persistenza.
Sunt din Olarașu, susțin mișcarea de rezistență.
Sunt Dorel Vișan.
Sunt Augustin Julea.
Sunt Ioana Barbu.
Sunt Maria Dinulescu.
Sunt Marius Manole.
Sunt din Olarașu.
Sunt Andreea Răducan.
Sunt Ana Ularu.
Sunt Răzvan Exarhu.
Sunt Mircea Danieliu.
Sunt Dr. Raed Arafat.
Sunt Florin Chilian.
Sunt Mircea Badea.
Sunt Marina Constantinescu.
Sunt Florin Piersic Junior.
Sunt John Răducanu.
Sunt Mircea Baniciu.
Sunt Dragoș Bucur.
Sunt Vasile Șeicaru.
Sunt Emiriț.
Sunt Bogdan Naumovici și susțin mișcarea de rezistență.